And sometimes in the interaction between humans and animals, there is some sort of, what should we say, silent communication.
First time I heard Black Crow on Tombstone, the song wasn't really finished. It was an unfinished version of it, but still, I immediately liked it a lot. And I remember some parts of it were the result of a jam that Satyricon and had like a weekend before. And we came up with some very good material on that jam. The very last. Eventually, very late in the night, Tyr said that I feel I've gotten what we need now. This is the kind of material that I want for this song. And he went out to a cabin in the woods and he was working on this material that we have recorded. And then he presents this song to me and it sounds so different than what we had been working on during the jam.
The thought behind the song lyrically had a little bit of a strange experience during one of our songwriting camps. I came, walked into the kitchen, and it was so gray and somber and just not nice at all on the outside. And I was just watching out the window, and his studio oversees a cemetery. And yeah, there was this crow that landed on a tombstone as I was watching, and I was paying attention to it. And it kept turning around, looking at me through the window, and I was going, why? What the hell did I do? Got the messenger, black crow, on a tombstone. But I think it was my state of mind, how I felt right there and then, the way it determinedly looked at me again and again, and almost pinpointed me, going, you. It was a fascinating and slightly bizarre experience. I wanted to try a little bit of animation. So when doing the video, it was important for me to have an animation company involved. I've never done anything like that before, and it's something that I wanted to do as well. I said, don't get too caught up in this crow thing, trying to make some like great storyline. Let's just try and use a little bit of the experiences that I had, a little bit of how you read the lyrics and my story, and make it go with the energy and the dynamics of the song.
I immediately liked the themes and the way they were sewn together, and how we got this really nice flow that gave it a certain masculine vibe.
After we had done the video, they had filmed some girl doing some whatever stuff in it without us even knowing, and they just put it in there, and I was like, aha.
What the? Subliminal messaging, maybe?
I think there are some small flashes of some girl covered in crow feathers and shit like that, but okay. I'm principally not really, I'm just tired of baiting videos, yeah.